Good morning. We are in the Lake District, just next to Wastwater, just driving on the road across that, and we are heading for Wastwater car park for Scafell Pike. We are going to try and summit Scafell Pike today, and if we're lucky and we can get to the other side, we're going to have a little look at a cheeky wild camp. Fingers crossed. As you can see, the Exos 48's in the back, just in shot there. Fully packed. I know I've forgot something, don't we always? I mean, the views around here are absolutely stunning. I'm gonna have to check out what mountain that is that you can see there right in front of you, but that looks really hard. Really steep and sharp. I think, where I'm going up, car all parked up, so just about to start the ascent now on the path. I'll be honest, from the bottom it looks absolutely massive, so let's see if we can get through this and get the rewards at the top. Right, so we're at the river crossing now. Gonna have to find a way to get over here without falling over with about 18 kilos on my back and selfie stick in my hand. It's gonna be a tricky one, this one. That's what I've got to get across. Oh my God, it gets steeper. I'll do it. Alright, so we're on a bit of a flat now, which is pretty good. The wind seems to have died down a little. I don't know if you can still hear it. But yeah, we're on this flat bit. Maybe you can still see the lake, but absolutely stunning location. But have you seen up there? Shit's about to get real. I've got to get up that. I don't know if you can see how steep it is on the camera, but my gosh, that is some hike. And I think that is the steep route, because looking up there, there's a load of people going that way. But I fancy going that way. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, do you like my new shades? Proper service station eye protection. Yeah, proper adventure goggles now, mate. Hope you like them. Don't know if you can see how steep this is. Looking up, it's probably hard, but the best thing to do is to look out there where I've come from. And then go like that. So I've got to go up there. And it's hard going, there's no steps now, so it's all gravel. And slippery and sliding. And the guy up there who I've sort of been following, I think he started rock climbing now, so that's going to be funny. We'll see what it's like when I get a bit further up. I mean, I've not really ever done rock climbing. And I've got about 18 kilos on my back, so. If you can see them. Oh, yeah, you can. Look at them.
How mad are they?
Yeah, yeah, we've got to climb. Done a bit of a scramble up that, I don't know what you call it, it's like a crevasse really. But yeah mate, look at these views now. That was well worth it mate. So Scafell Pike is just over there, you can see it. I think I found a spot, I could see it from the top of there. Top of Scafell. Not done much filming. So many people up here. It's a bit, still a bit new to this, aren't I? So, and a bit embarrassing just whipping the old camera out and just start talking to myself in front of a crowd of people. It's a bit weird, isn't it? Yeah. So basically, when I was at the top, tried to find what's it called now, sprinkling tarn, but it's miles away and it's another summit on the way as well. My legs haven't got that after that hard hike up. So yeah, from the top I've seen this little tarn, I don't know what it's called, and I can get a dunk in the morning and a cold water therapy for these knees and thighs from that climb up. So yeah, I underestimate big time. Anyway, we'll see you in a bit when we're there. Oh, I'll tell you what, I'll give you a shot of this view. Yeah, that wasn't in the brochure. Traverse now, so we'll have a go. One-handed, obviously. Oh, it's not too bad. Good work, and it was. Whoop. Oh, put a fork in me. I am done. Yeah, underestimated today, absolutely knackered, but for this view that I'm looking out at now, unbelievable. I'll show you now, do you want to see? I've changed my mind, we're not staying where we were before. It was too windy and basically I want to bring you to Tarn, so really, really wanted to go to Sprinkling Tarn, and I didn't realise on the map I was looking at how far it was to the scene on the west map. But I reckon if I give it a good scramble now for an hour, we'll get you there and we'll get a dunk in the morning. So yeah, we'll catch up with you in a bit. I won't be filming now for the next hour because I'm just going to try and put the pedal down. But yeah, see you in a bit mate. I know I said I wouldn't film till I get to that place, but have you seen this frigging path I've just had to walk on? Literally clinging to the wall, and it's a sheer drop down there, look.
I've got to get up there in a minute.
Jesus Christ, I wish I'd have stayed where I was. Fuck.
Beautiful waterfall over there though.
Hey, well, we made it down to the tarn, so probably going to have a dip in the morning. The only problem is I've now got no phone signal, which was a schoolboy error, because I did up there. So we've come quite a way really. It's not too bad, because I've got these views from the side of the tent. I think is
It's going to be pretty nice. It's going to be a nice evening. Bottle of wine there. I'll get set up in a bit. There's still a few people on the path. So we're all set up now next to this tarn. I still don't know the name of it because I've got no signal now. But I'll find out and I'll put it in the comments or something. Well, yeah, so set up. I had some rice up there earlier on. Up there somewhere where you can see. It was a cracking spot. The view of this was just beautiful. And even down to the lake down there was amazing. But there was just so much wind. And right now there's no wind. So here we are. So yeah, I've bought a nice bottle of wine tonight. If you can see it. Okay. It's a Rioja. Bit of rubbish on that as well there. So we're going to have a go with this. But the problem is, I haven't got a cup again. So I'm going to have to drink it out the bottle. When in Rome, do as the Romans do. We'll have a little go and see what it's like, eh? I always carry one of these with me as well when I'm about. I know you can get lighter ones, but I just like this. It's just it's nicely made, I think. Anyway, I'm waffling. Let's have a go at this. I think I'll be having an early night tonight. I'm absolutely knackered. Done in. It's been a brilliant day though. It's been spot on, mate. Some of the views that I've seen, and it's an achievement doing Scafell as well. I'm made up with that. It was a lot of effort, I must admit, and sometimes I was well out of my comfort zone with some of them traverses and gullies and things that I had to climb, especially with that pack on my back. It's probably about 18 kilos, but do you know what? I've done it now, and the walk back from here, I've got to go. Let's have a look. So, you know, I've got to go. Up here, round over the top, and then it's just all downhill. It's all the way downhill, and it's not all trail as well. You reach a road, and then you walk on the road back to the car park there by Wastwater Lake. So, put the effort in today. Don't have to do as much tomorrow. Get home. Father's Day tomorrow as well. So, happy Father's Day to all you dads out there. Anyway, I'm waffling again. Let's get on this. It's lovely here, isn't it? Nice. I think I better be sipping that. 13.5%. Lovely. 15 quid bottle of wine, and I haven't even got a glass. Drink it out of the bottle. Like. Those of you who watched my last video with the when we went to Mermaid's Pool and up came the scouts and dunked Mermaid's Pool and whatnot, you probably remember the Cedar Summit broccoli and salmon pasta that looked like baby sick. I was gutted with that, it cost me over a tenner. Anyway, I've gone for another dehydrated meal for me tea. I've gone for just from Go Outdoors, really. It was Go Outdoors, yeah. 5 quid. It's Adventure food, chicken curry, 600 calories, as Di would say, not the fat boy edition. So we're going to give this a go. So I'm going to measure the water. No. It says to put up to mark 9. So we're going to try that. That's my tea. Now we've got a problem. In the midst of buying all this kit that I've bought, and my mate Di Outdoors over on Instagram, go and check him out. We've both been buying all this kit, and I bought a Sawyer Squeeze or a Sawyer Mini water filter, and I forgot that I hadn't bought one. Yeah, I know it sounds really daft, but I forgot I hadn't bought a water filter and came up here with about 3 litres of water. So all I've got left is this, and I need 400 mil for me food. So we're gonna have to see what happens. That's not too bad. We've filled it up, got our 400 mil in there. I'm gonna chuck it on now. Water left for tomorrow's descent. That's it. But that's all I've got. That's me supping on the way down. I've probably got a 3 mile hike left. But obviously as soon as I pass the garage, I can go and grab some water on the way home, so.
Jet Boil, give us a sponsor.
Alright, so she's boiled. I don't know how many videos I can do with this Jet Boil, but it's all I'm doing. So anyway, let's have a go at this. The Adventure Food says on the back, open the top from the notch. They're only cheap these in consideration to the bigger makes. Open it up. Have a look inside. It's all like rice and stuff. Smells nice. Open the bottom. Stuff it down. Right, she's just boiled. So that's 400 mil in there. Let's have a go.
Line 9, it says.
Nice, that's all it's getting.
Is that all it's getting?
If this looks like baby sick again, I am going to be fuming. Nice. Right, let it sit for 8 minutes. All right, it has been over 8 minutes. So we're gonna have a look at the Adventure Food chicken curry poultry. Yeah, it's been in there for 8 minutes, probably over if I'm being honest, but is it gonna be another baby sick pouch? Wow. There we go. Now that looks like chicken and rice to me. I mean, granted, similar tones to baby sick, but that looks like what it says on the tin. That is chicken curry with rice. So here we go. We're going to give it a try now. I'll let you know what it's like. I mean, it looks amazing. It does look really good. Completely different to that summer to eat broccoli and salmon pasta. I don't know why. I mean, they're supposed to be one of the best and a lot of people do rave over them. I do need to try the other ones that they do, but that particular one just did not work. Anyway, less slagging off. Let's try this one from Go Outdoors. It's hot, it's very hot. Gotta go for a second bite before they give me a verdict. Try and find a bit of chicken. I'm gonna go with 4 out of 10. Not a massive amount of flavour. I mean, am I coming from this from the wrong angle? Am I expecting gourmet food? I don't know. But, I mean, don't get me wrong, it'll fill me up and it'll be quite nice. I should have brought some salt. I might have some salt. We'll see. Morning. Yep.
Weather's turned for the worst. It's 4:30 in the morning. I fell asleep last night, mate. Must have been 9:30. I've not even finished my wine. Didn't review the meal. I tell you what did happen with that beer, well.
Horrific hiccups.
I don't know why. But yeah, I'm going to pack up in a minute. I've had a cracking sleep. Really, really good sleep. So I'll pack up. First time I've ever packed up in rain, so we'll see what happens here. And then we'll foxtrot out of here.
Pretty bleak up here, guys. I won't be filming much on the way back to the car. It is treacherous. I woke up in a horrible sort of just a rainstorm, really. In fact, I'm in the clouds here as well. So yeah, I'm gonna head down to the car. Hopefully I'll be back there for, well, I don't even know. I want to do it in less than 2 hours. I want to get back. It's Father's Day, innit? But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you on the next time. Peace. Thank you.